Welcome to Cows and Climate. My name is Frank Mitloehner, and I'm a professor and air quality specialist in the Department of Animal Science at UC Davis. I've been researching this area of environmental impacts of livestock over the last 20 years. I've been monitoring and modeling those impacts and have done so regionally, nationally, and internationally. California is the number one agricultural state in the country, where we produce 90% of all nuts, 50% of all fruits and vegetables, 20% of all dairy. We're the number four beef producing state. We are really an agricultural powerhouse here, and I sit right in the midst of it. My goal throughout these videos is to separate facts from fiction around livestock's impact on the environment, and in particular, livestock impact on climate. Let me put greenhouse gases into perspective. I speak throughout the world on the impact livestock has on climate because we oftentimes hear myths that livestock are the greatest detriment, the greatest threat to our climate worldwide. This global comparison has been falsely applied to the United States, and that has really led to some far-reaching consequences and consumer deception. Livestock's contribution to climate varies greatly throughout different regions, different production systems, different climates, and so forth. And it's very important to introduce nuance into this discussion. What is not helping us is to put out a global average. For example, back in 1950, we used to have 25 million dairy cows in the United States. 25. Today, we have 9 million dairy cows, so much fewer. But while we have so much fewer cows today than we used to, we're producing 60% more milk today than we used to with a herd that was almost three times that size. And that means we have reduced the carbon footprint of a glass of milk by two-thirds over this period of time. These increases in efficiency and decreases in emissions are a direct result of four main factors: reproductive efficiency, establishment of a veterinary care system where we prevent or treat diseases, the introduction of improved genetics, and the feeding of more energy-dense diets. These four factors have allowed us to shrink livestock numbers to historic lows. For example, we here in the United States produce about 23,000 pounds of milk per cow per year. In Mexico, that number would be a quarter of that. In India, each cow there produces about 1/20th the amount of milk as one cow here, meaning that it takes 5 cows in Mexico, 20 cows in India to produce the same amount of milk as one cow here. And that has profound impacts on the environmental performance of these animals. Unfortunately, all of this nuance gets lost when global averages are used. So the question is, how much emissions are produced by livestock, for example, cows? Well, the numbers we normally put a lot of trust into are those by the Environmental Protection Agency. The EPA looks at all the different sectors of society, including agriculture, and has established that animal agriculture in the United States contributes to 3.9, let's call that 4% of all greenhouse gases in the United States. Just to give you an idea, there are three sectors: transportation, power production and use, and certain industries such as cement industry. These three fossil fuel consuming industries combined are responsible for 80% of greenhouse gases produced in this country. And again, now contrast that to 4% from livestock. In California, for example, livestock is responsible for about 4%. The lion's share of that comes from dairy. Transportation is 10 times that, 40%. There's very little doubt among climate scientists that the most important human contribution to climate change is the use of fossil fuels: oil, coal, gas. That's carbon that was stored in the ground for millions of years. And within a very short period of time, a few decades, we have taken a lot of that carbon out, we have burned it, and now it's in the atmosphere. And that is the 800-pound gorilla we are wrestling with. Climate science is clear about that. Some of the activists are not. They couldn't be further from the truth.